What is going on, everybody? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I'm glad that you're back with me today. Now, if you are anything like me, you've been shopping around for a new iPad Pro, but those storage prices that Apple charges to upgrade the internal SSD is just highway robbery. Well, this is the accessory for you. This is the Samsung X5, and this is a Thunderbolt 3 drive that connects to your iPad Pro, your MacBook Pro, your M1 Mac Mini, any device really, and it can scale the internal storage for what is reasonable cost compared to what Apple charges for it. Now, let's get started. Now, when I say fast storage, this is uncompromised, balls to the wall, fast as can be, 40 gigabytes per second, read-write speed using Thunderbolt 3. This is the premium experience that you deserve on your new iPad Pro. It's really a great way to either expand the amount of storage that you have internally to your device or as an adjunct, something to carry around with you when you're working with large audio or video files. This is really a premium experience that Samsung's delivering on the Samsung X5. Now, not priced for the faint of heart. It starts at $199 for 500 gigs, $349 for 1 terabyte, or an amazing $560 for 2 terabytes. Now, I'll put links down in the description below in case you're interested in picking anything up. Now, while these prices do sound expensive, this is relatively low cost per gigabyte, when you compare that against Apple and what they charge for integrated storage on their devices. Now, the thing about this is that the read-write speeds that you're gonna be able to get with this drive are very similar to what you would experience using an internal drive, and that's all based on Thunderbolt 3 technology. It is an all-metal enclosure, and it does get warm, so I think that metal is gonna be used to dissipate the heat. It's available in this two-tone, this gray on one side and the red on the other, and it comes with a Thunderbolt cable inside the box. Now, I know what you're probably thinking, Mike, why would I spend, you know, $200 plus on a portable SSD when I can go buy, you know, ones that are 60 bucks, 80 bucks, maybe even 120 bucks? That's a really great question. And what I would tell you is that the difference is the amount of throughput that you're going to get with this. Those drives are connecting to your iPad, to your Mac, whatever the case is, using USB-C. That USB-C protocol is going to be maxed at 10 gigabits per second. So this is really 4 times the amount of bandwidth at 40 gigabits per second. That's how fast it is able to read, write data through that link. Now, if you are unfamiliar with Thunderbolt, this is a technology that uses a single cable to connect to a device. That single cable is capable of transferring data at the rate of 40 gigabits per second, which is like insanely fast when you think about it. It's actually 4 times faster than USB-C, which you find in the current 2020 iPad Pro and even the previous generation of that, the 2018. In addition to being able to transfer data at 40 gigabits per second via a single cable, you can also charge devices on that cable. You can connect other peripherals like a display. I have a RAID controller for my computer. It's really kind of robust in the amount of accessories that are available. There are even Thunderbolt audio accessories like audio interfaces. So there's a lot out there. Hopefully Apple brings the whole breadth of Thunderbolt accessories to the iPad. Not sure if we're gonna see that this year at WWDC or not. Let me know in the comments below if you're excited for WWDC, because I know I am. Now I can take this X5 SSD, connect this to my Mac here, and it will connect via single cable that I plugged into the back of my Thunderbolt dock. So I actually have a dock that expands the number of ports. Now, when I plug this into my computer, it does show as a mounted drive, just like how any other drive works on Mac, and it works the same way on iPadOS. I'm gonna plug this in. Let's run a speed disk test to see how fast it is with this drive. Now, the first drive that we're gonna test is gonna be the internal drive on my M1 MacBook Pro. This is obviously internal. It's integrated into the unified memory. So this should be a very fast experience and it should yield very fast results. Let's test it out. Now I'm gonna select the source drive. I'm gonna select my home folder. Click start. And you can see here, I'm getting roughly 2,800 megabits on read and write, which is really kind of remarkable if you think about it. The speed that's being demonstrated here on an internal all integrated drive that's directly on the board. Now, next, we're gonna go ahead and test a Samsung T5, which is a conventional SSD drive that uses USB-C to connect to my Mac. Now, while I'm setting this up, the tool that I'm using to test this is from Blackmagic. It's a Blackmagic speed test. Or Blackmagic speed drive test. I'll put a link down in the description below in case you want to use it in the future. This is an app that will allow you to go ahead and test various media sizes, and it'll go ahead and report back on what your performance would be from the drive based on different types of media that are used for, say, video editing. So here we're gonna go ahead and test this in. And now you could see here, this is considerably slower than what the last drive was, maxing out just under 400 megabytes per second on the read and the write. It is getting considerably slower. We think about this in comparison to the first one, we are at the very, very far end of the spectrum in terms of speed. And last but not least, this is gonna be the test of the Samsung X5 Thunderbolt 3 SSD. Now we're plugging this in, we're gonna select the drive just like we did before, we're gonna use all the same kind of parameters for the testing. Click start. And you can see here that we are getting roughly 2000 megabytes per second on the write and 2500 megabytes per second on the read, which is actually pretty close to what you're getting on the internal drive. So from a testing perspective, even though it is not like for like, where you're getting roughly, again, you know, 2500 and 2800 megabytes per second, Thunderbolt drive is going to give you the closest experience of what you would actually have with an internal drive here. One of the things that I like to do to figure out how much this is going to cost me is I like to calculate what is the cost per gigabyte that I'm paying when I'm buying a mass storage device. So here, if I'm looking at the very entry level tier, I'm paying $200 and I'm getting 500 gigs. Now, when I do the calculations, that's just a little bit more than 39 cents per gigabyte to own this drive. Now, if I go to the next level up, it's going to be 1000 gigabytes. I'm paying $350. That's going to be about 35 cents per gigabyte to buy this drive. And it's actually almost the same thing for the 2 terabyte drive. Now, when you look at these costs and you compare them against Apple's charging for upgrading your storage, it's actually going to be quite shocking how much you're actually paying with Apple. For example, on the 12.9 inch entry level iPad Pro, you're getting 128 gigs of storage for $1,099. If you want to upgrade to the 512, that's $1,399, or a difference of 300 bucks. Now, if you take that $300 and you divide that by the cost per gigabyte, you're paying roughly 58 cents per gigabyte to upgrade to this device, which is actually going to be a kind of a lot of money if you think about it. They're almost two thirds of the price more than what you're paying for when you buy this externally. And not that there's not a performance difference, because you are going to get a little bit better performance on an internal drive versus an external drive, just based on the architecture and how it works, but it's not very much different. So at the end of the day, you have to ask yourself, is it worth spending $199 plus on the Samsung X5 when you can get many different competitors for a much cheaper price? The answer, in my opinion, is going to be yes, and this can be based on three things. So one, the interface technology between the drive and your computer is Thunderbolt 3. It's very robust, extremely fast, 40 gigabits per second, meaning that you should be able to scale this and transfer data from your iPad again to the drive in blazing fast speeds. This cable itself not only can be used to power the drive, you can use it, you can plug it into a USB-C adapter. It can be used to power your computer, to power another accessory, whatever the case is. It is backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3. You can actually use it to transfer data between a USB-C device. So the cable itself and the medium is very flexible. Two, the storage controller technology is going to be NVMe, or non-volatile memory express. It is an extremely fast storage controller technology. It does allow for read-write speeds up to 2000 megabytes per second. When you compare that against other drives, you're going to get something that supports SSD or even M2. Those are going to max out at somewhere between 600 and about 1000 megabytes per second. Still, this is double the speed of that. Three is going to be the additional features in the drive. It has a 3-year warranty. It has drop protection up to 2 meters, and there are thermal protections inside the drive because it does run hot. All those things, in my opinion, makes it a very easy recommendation whether you're looking to add external storage for your drive because you want to keep large projects on there, if you want a way to adding internal space to your iPad or your computer at relatively low cost, still maintaining the same read-write speeds which you get on your Mac, your iPad. So I think it's a very easy recommendation, but what I'd love to know is from what you think. Are you thinking about this drive, or are you thinking about it as a way to circumvent Apple's high prices that they charge for their internal storage? Let me know in the comments below. My name is Mike. Folks, I will talk to you in the next one.